do the thing up there, but we are jumping into game four now.
What a clash from both sides. We did see the swift finish for the ending of match three, but we are going into the next match, game four, Team First Blood versus Bloodhounds. Who will prevail? Two wins on the side of Team First Blood. If they take this game, Bloodhounds will be knocked down to the lower bracket.
And JoyBuzz already kind of being aggressive, getting a little bit slow here though, maybe backing off, but still, I think this is what we're gonna see from him. Ashley as well thrives on the Lunox. We're gonna gotta keep our eyes on her when she's sitting in these bushes, waiting for the ambushes, waiting to make those Ruby DD plays.
These teams don't miss a beat, always going in for the clash. And Bocorosco able to take out Ashley. We're not even 1 minute in, and we have a first blood for the favor of Bloodhounds.
And pretty typical, right? Bloodhounds, like you said, they don't miss a beat. They want to bring the heat immediately, and we might be in for another bloodbath here. JoyBuzz still keeping vision for his team. Kid just kind of taking his time, and this is something we've kind of seen from Kid recently, even on the Amon and now on this Akai. He's like, listen, if you guys die out there, it's okay. I'm going to keep farming in these early laning phases. Sometimes I think that's the issue for Team First Blood, but then also it can work out. Normally, their roamer Kid doesn't get too involved in the early phases. He just kind of focuses on farming up.
Yeah, and you didn't see really too much contest over on the jungler for Easy Peasy, able to get the farm needed, but a clash on the bottom side. Cho trying to go in for some CC on Dim Sum. Speaking of CC, Kid with the heavy spin, but the additional heavy spin by Bocorosco, a little bit of a Beyblade action in the mid lane.
Yeah, that was the real Beyblade right there. Normally we say it, wait a second, but nothing too major over here. Normally we say it with the Ballman and the Akai, but this time two Akais just bounce, bounce, bounce. Definitely something enjoyable for us all to see, right? But Turtle is up now. Let's see who takes this.
Easy Peasy going in for the damage. Bocorosco going for a little bit of zone, as you do see Sushi with a possible conceal play. He has level 4. Fatal Links is in the game, and it looks like Turtle does go to Bloodhounds with no contest.
Team First Blood just kind of biding their time right now, and I like the fact that they didn't feel like they needed it, so they just back off. They don't waste time. A lot of teams get too caught up wanting that Turtle, but they do back up. But with that, they start to fall a little bit behind in gold here, and a big Fatal Links.
Fatal Links on Gina and able to take out the Marksman for Team First Blood. JoyBuzz able to take out Dim Sum as well. Both Marksmans have fallen, and both teams decide to push off.
Yeah, Marksman for Marksman. So Team First Blood find a nice answer there. Just when it looks grim, they're able to strike back. JoyBuzz making that play happen. Both tanks on both teams right now making some plays happen. So who will be the big playmaker in the end, right? Is Sushi gonna land off with these Fatal Links and change the tides? Or are we gonna see JoyBuzz continue to get some way of the dragons? We are seeing Team First Blood kind of hover down onto this gold lane right now.
Ooh, speaking of the way of the dragon, kicking him, but into the tower, and he possibly will be taken out. Ashley able to take out Dim Sum. JoyBuzz without any HP. Bocorosco trying to go in for the kill. The mobility of JoyBuzz able to escape. You see Gina going in over there on the Wanwa. Will she be able to get the crossbow tank, activating those weakness points and taking out Bocorosco in the mid lane? The heavy spin by Kid for the zone is to clear the minions.
I love the fact that during that, JoyBuzz sees Bocorosco coming, so he waits in the bush a little bit longer, bides a little bit of time, and then uses the second shield to get away. Waits for Bocorosco to kind of check the top side of the bush. If he would have showed his face too early, Bocorosco would have dashed in, probably killed him. Known exactly where he was going, but that slight element of surprise, the slight question, is what kept him alive there.
Both teams just neck and neck, 3-2. But look at Easy Peasy. Look at the fight in the mid lane as well. JoyBuzz again trying to escape with any HP. He barely has any, and Tipless able to capitalize, taking out JoyBuzz. A little bit of an overaggression behind enemy lines and is very costly. 3-3 right now. Another turtle play. We did see Bloodhounds take the first one, no contest. Do we see them taking the second one? We don't see the proper zonage from Team First Blood, and it looks like they may be able to secure it. And down goes the turtle for Easy Peasy. Luffy trying to go in for some peel, but you do see the two stack on a Tipless and Easy Peasy on the chase, and Luffy able to escape.
And now they do try to find answers down here in the boss side, maybe able to find it on Dim Sum.
Oh my goodness, what a clash. Kid going down, hitting the heavy spin on Dim Sum. You do see Dim Sum able to connect and take out the marksman. Gina has fallen, and Dim Sum able to possibly escape. The question is, does he push back? You see the fight from Boca Roscoe trying to take out Kid, and Joybots trying to take out Boca Roscoe. The 3v1 situation right now, and the Fatal Links has been activated by Tsuchi. But the way the dragon just in time to secure a kill over on Boca Roscoe, but the mid lane has fallen. The pressure of Easy Peasy and Templates versus Luffy. You do see the Last Insanity going down and connecting, and down goes Luffy.
So the Last Insanity, the burn, the true damage does work pretty well against Luffy, right? It works well against those tanky people. Not only that, but the Aerithyl. We gotta break down the Aerithyl for a second, because not only does it do well against the Wanwan, but it does well against so many of these divey, pushy heroes. Gina should be able to escape from this, but even with a Kai, when he brought in the heavy spin, you can just run away from him and continue to shoot, but you're not getting away from this. A big pick on a Dim Sum.
What a focus over there from Joybots, going straight to Dim Sum and using the weight of the dragon, providing a set and a kill for their team. But speaking of sets, you do see the Fatal Links connecting, and the fight continues. Easy Peasy able to take out Ashley and going in for the double, taking out Joybots. A defensive nature, a defensive stance, one from the side of Bloodhounds. But in the mid lane, look at Kid just pushing in that tower.
Yeah, trying to do something here. I think he should be able to get away from this. And you talked about win conditions. Wait a second.
Oh my goodness, the heavy spin pinning them possibly on the wall, but also using it as a maneuverability to escape. But Tipless on the chase and taking out Kid. And then you see the next turtle has spawned in. Bloodhounds was able to secure the first two. And again, a similar pattern, able to take the third turtle.
Yeah, that is huge. Luffy at least getting something up in this top side. And like I was saying, you mentioned win conditions being on these Fatal Links. And right now, Tsuchi is finding it. He's securing the win condition against the odds of having this Wanwan who can break CC, against the odds of Ashley being able to use Brilliance to get away from things. He's finding the moments to strike, and he's making it work. So doing an amazing job in my eyes right now on this Atlas. Even when a lot of the enemy composition can get away from those moves, he's making sure it counts.
Yes, exactly. Well said. You see Bloodhounds just getting the gold lead, getting the advantage, trying to get a snowball over on Team First Blood. Right now, just looking at like a 4,000 lead in gold. Speaking of the advantage, Joybots going in with the weight of the dragon on a Dim Sum, but able to escape over there on Aerithyl with the mobility.
And Gina, with being at 1-3-3 right now, definitely pretty far behind. Yes, Dim Sum also has three deaths, but it feels like Dim Sum has already kind of hit it a little bit, starting to find some moments, find a stride. Has the Wind Talker in, gonna start working on the Berserker's Fury next, and once that locks in, we're looking at some big damage. Paired up with the burn and the true damage coming from Easy Peasy could definitely be enough to get through the front line of Team First Blood.
Speaking of frontline, you do see the Fatal Links connecting, getting a double send, Easy Peasy capitalizing, taking out some of the players of Team First Blood. They are down Ashley, they are down Kid, and it looks like Bloodhounds is on for the push. They are in for the pressure. They will go in and steal the jungle and push the lanes.
And I mean, Tsuchi just continues to make count. A nice wave of the dragon. Maybe not enough to finish this off, though. Dim Sum putting on pressure back.
It looks like they were going to try and go in for the kill. Dim Sum able to escape. Will they be able to recall, though? You do see Boca Roscoe going in a 3v2 situation. Boca Roscoe securing the kill over on Gina, which will allow them to push in that top tower. You do see Lord spawning in, not Luminous, just regular non-enhanced Lord. Looks like Easy Peasy is going to go for this objective again. Hasn't really had a hard time inside of that jungle. And another tower falls over on the top side. What a play. The mid lane tower has fallen as well, leaving only the inhibitors for the top and bottom lane. 14 first, but the clash is going on for the Lord, though. You do see Easy Peasy able to secure it with the Retribution. Last Insanity has been activated, but unable to deal any damage to the members of Team First Blood, but they were able to secure the Lord.
And that is huge, Bloodhounds. I mean, are we going to a game five, Weezy? Are we about to have two full best of fives in a row? Because right now it looks like that's what Bloodhounds want here. They're gonna sync up these waves. They're doing a pretty good job. They're coming at this at all angles right now, and it's looking very rough for Team First Blood as Lord crashes in.
I definitely agree. This may be a possible game five. Lord pushing in the mid lane. You do see the contest from Team First Blood, but the heavy pressure from Bloodhounds, but unable to take a tower, and they are forced on the retreat and are going to prepare for another Lord. Man, this is just such a crazy game. Like we said, the winning conditions for Atlas was to be able to provide the CC, not waste the Fatal Links, and that is what we have seen. This just the insane sets that he's able to provide for the team and not using them too early, and I think that is going to be the deciding factor when we do go for the final clash.
Yeah, this is very similar to what we saw last time Bloodhounds won, right? They just started scaling up. They started putting pressure in. It starts to become a bit of trouble. Joybaj, and not only that, but Boca Roscoe, man, he had so many troubles with his Valentina before, and now he's stealing all the right ultimates at the right times, right there with the Brilliance, able to get away from Joybaj there. Just a clutch play.
Wow, look at Luffy, able to escape, forcing Easy Peasy to use the last Insanity and not able to do any damage. They are down an ultimate from Easy Peasy right now. A solid defense from Team First Blood. They are trying to remain in this fight. They do not want to give Bloodhounds the advantage to even out the playing field. They do not want to allow them to take this to a game five. Like we said, if Bloodhounds is taken out here, Team First Blood will move to the top four. But a clash over on the bottom side. Luffy caught with the four enemies of Bloodhound. And then we see all teams going down to the bottom lane to clash it out. You see the kills going down. Boca Roscoe taking out Luffy. What a play. But Dim Sum has fallen over to Gina. Tipless on the retreat. You see Sushi able to escape, but Tipless not as lucky and falls to Gina.
All right, so Team First Blood finally finds an answer. They may be able to take this mid tower as well. Boca Roscoe kind of hiding out, but he doesn't want to do this. He knows he needs to play it safe. Cut, you know, let them take a little something. Maybe not too much. Ashley coming in though.
Oh, you do see the way the dragon connecting over on Sushi, and possibly down goes Joybaj, but Astley answering, taking out Sushi. They are trying to get the finish, trying to take out Bloodhounds. Boca Roscoe able to get the kill over on Astley. You see the heavy presence on Bloodhounds right now in the mid lane. I don't know, Trex. This is neck and neck right now for these teams.
I'm almost wondering if Gina should have left that fight that early. Ashley does end up going down there, and I can't help but wonder if she could have made a huge play there. Now, she's doing good right now. Average damage, I mean, Gina just overall has done a great job. This game, though, she's having a little bit of trouble. But just like last time on the Clint, once she does get online, it could be huge.
Speaking of huge, Gina able to get a kill over on Boca Roscoe, but Lord for Easy Peasy able to be secured, and one member down. Boca Roscoe is down for Bloodhounds. They are forced on the retreat, but they were able to get some insurance from securing the Luminous Lord.
Yeah, now Luminous Lord will be coming towards Team First Blood, but also Team First Blood starting to win out a bit in these fights. Are going to make quick work of this Lord with Gina behind them, though. Watch out for Joybaj because he wants to make that play happen, but he knows he can't do it alone.
Ooh, heavy aggression from Gina without really that much frontline. A little risky, but Dim Sum sneaking behind and able to take out Astley, but at what cost? Joybaj trying to go in, trying to get the kill, trying to take out that marksman, but Dim Sum able to escape. Gina getting out as well. Luminous Lord pushing in on the mid lane in the favor for Bloodhounds. Will they be able to get the finish? Luffy trying to give some pill and some zoners. Luminous Lord does fall, but both teams just fighting it out. You see the chase, the Falling Star Moon from Esmeralda connecting on Luffy. Easy peasy as well. Atlas going in. Do we see a Fatal Links? Oh my goodness, what a play. The heavy spin to Easy Peasy, forcing him behind enemy lines into the tower, and down he goes.
He brought him all the way home with him, all the way back to the base. I mean, literally from the second tower nub all the way back to home base. He's like, you're not leaving. You're mine right now. And Easy Peasy goes down. But before that, Dim Sum, this Aerithel with the sprint is just so clutch. I thought for sure Dim Sum was dead, walked right into the bush, gets caught by Ashley, but Ashley wasn't able to finish it, and Dim Sum pops the sprint along with the ultimate and ends up taking out Ashley in response, and then able to sprint away, get away, because if you're trying to chase down an Aerithel with sprint, well, the ultimate is popped, it's just death. You're just walking into a face full of crossbow hits. So right now, working very well against the composition of Team First Blood.
And you love the way this match is going. You can never tell who is going to take the victory. Bloodhounds has to win this game or they will be knocked down to the lower bracket. But they are putting up a fight and they have more towers than Team First Blood. But I think, Trex, this is going to come down, like we said, to the clash, to the prioritization, to the XP lane, cutting those lanes while the Lord does spawn in to create the opportunity for your team.
One thing I can say about Bloodhounds right now is I feel like they have a couple more. Oh, Templates getting pinned to the wall here.
Ooh, speaking of cuts, you do see them going in for Templates, taking some serious damage, but possibly able to escape. You do see Gina able to connect and take him out. Bocarasco taking out Luffy. Gina taking out Dimsum. The marksman has fallen for the side of Bloodhounds, and they are on the heavy push for the side of Team First, but they are going in. But at what cost? Is it too much over aggression? Ashley caught in the tower. Bocarasco taking out Ashley. Kid is well caught behind, but able to dash out just in time, but putting that pressure on Bloodhounds, trying to go for a finish, but able to escape.
Yeah, maybe going a little too deep. Ashley biting off a bit more than she can chew there. Didn't need to make that dive. They'd already gotten two kills. You could have just backed off and you would have had a huge advantage as we creep into this Lord fight, Weezy.
Speaking of advantage, they do have Sushi over there on Atlas. They have the zonage and this is a high objective. This is Luminous Lord, 15 minutes in. Both teams need this. They need this advantage. And speaking of advantage, the clash going down. Last Insanity activated, comboed with the Retribution, securing the Lord. But who will win the fight? That is going to be the game changer. This will determine a possible winner. But looks like both teams are going to push off, play it safe, but leaning in the favor for Bloodhounds, able to secure that Luminous Lord pushing down the mid lane.
Man, but Team First Blood feels confident about it. Gina just melting down that Lord. I got a feeling if no big sec, watch this. Gina walking right in Templates right now.
Oh my goodness, you see Gina able to escape. But yes, that Lord just got shredded. It's just looking like non-enhanced Lords the way they're taking it out with no contest. And right now, just some solid defense from Team First Blood.
And we got, I mean, I got a feeling we may be in for a bit of a long game here, the way these Lords are getting melted down. If no big mistakes come from either team, if no huge pins or huge fatal links come, we could be in for a little while here. It's going to be another minute, 2 minutes until the next Lord pops up. Both teams down to inhibitors. Neither of them have cracked, so overall the macro of the super minions is pretty even. Now, Bloodhounds do hold a little bit of a gold lead here, but so far that hasn't seemed to been an issue majorly for Team First Blood. They know they're at a bit of deficit, they know how to play around it, and here comes Way of the Dragon.
Clash in the mid lane, trying to get the advantage. Last Insanity going down from Easy Peasy to do some AoE damage, chasing down Kid. The full team of Bloodhounds trying to secure the kill, and down goes Kid from Bocarasco. You see the full team of Team First Blood trying to answer back, trying to take out Templates. Gina on the chase, but unable to connect. Can Templates get away? Luffy able to take out Templates, and you see Dimsum raining down with Irithel on damage. Luffy forced on the retreat. 1-for-1 trade.
So I like the thoughts about that team fight from Team First, where they're like, Ashley was kind of sitting in that bush waiting. She let that fight go on for a solid like 5-10 seconds almost before she made the engage. And what they're trying to do is kind of bait them in a little bit. That way Ashley can try to get the one shot onto Boca or onto Dimsum, right? But the thing is Bloodhounds didn't fall for that. They didn't go too deep. They just kind of focused on to Kid there and ended up picking the kill. Luckily, Team First Blood able to respond back by getting something for themselves, not just losing out.
You did see a little bit of a conceal play over there by Cho, wasted without an opportunity. And now we see Lord, Luminous Lord will be spawning in 27 seconds. I think this is that similar situation. It's gonna come down to cutting that XP lane, going in, trying to take the Lord, trying to get some kills as well, down to a bloodbath for a finish for both sides.
That's definitely gonna come down to the line here, down to something similar of what we saw last game. Can Sushi pull it off, or will Kid or Joybush get the play that matters? You know, both teams really kind of playing it down. Bocarasco, though,
Gina able to get rough. In behind enemy lines and take out the mage, but at what cost? Last Insanity going down, trying to take out Gina, able to dash out with the mobility of 1-1. Astley securing the kill, taking out the marksman for Bloodhounds. The marksman and the mage are down. This is the time to take that lord or go for a finish. They are going to go for this lord, knowing they don't have the damage. They don't have the proper zone to be able to push it and stop Team First Blood from taking this Luminous Lord. You see Luffy with the contest. You see Joybosh with the contest as well. And Kid is able to take the Luminous Lord.
Yeah, taking two deaths right now at this late in the game. Those death counters are very large. Both of them are at 38 seconds. Bloodhound's going to lose a lot off of this push, especially because Team First Blood doesn't even want to wait for the Lord. They're going to keep on putting on pressure, open up the map, so when the Lord does start crashing in, they're already at inhibitors, and those inhibitors are already pretty low. High possibility that Team First Blood, if they don't take the base here, they could take two, possibly all three of these inhibitors right now.
And looks like we might be getting a little bit of sinkage in the lanes. You do see Wanwan over on the bottom side. Gina prepping for this sink. They are going to try and go for a finish. The question is, will Bloodhounds allow it? A lot on the line. Bloodhounds cannot let them take this tower. If Bloodhounds does fall in this match, they will be knocked down to the lower bracket. Lord pushing in over on the top side. You do see the class, the last Insanity as well might be procced. You see Luffy for the zone as the tower falls on top side. Luminous Lord is in the base. You do see the heavy class, heavy spell. Oh my gosh, the Fatal Links does connect, but unable to grab anybody. What a play from both sides. But Luminous Lord does fall. Will this be the defense that Bloodhounds needs? Will they be able to hold them off? You do see Gina able to secure kill over on Dim Sum. They are down a marksman. Astley able to secure the kill over on Tipless. Gina taking another tower. Minions are pushing in all directions, forcing Bloodhounds to have a hard time defending. Will they be able to hold off the full team? A crossbow tank possibly being activated. Luffy taking out Easy Peasy. Kid taking out Atlas. Look at that tower. Half health. Boca Roscoe taking out Luffy, leaving only Boca Roscoe to defend, and down goes Boca Roscoe. End game goes to Team First Blood. Bloodhounds goes to the lower bracket.
That is huge. And what? Take a breath, Wheezy, because that was a long finish there. Once again, the perseverance from both of these teams, Team First Blood.